My friends in Christ, may our Lord Jesus be the strong foundation of our faith for life and ministry. Amen. One of my clergy friends today is going to have a very trying day. He serves a parish in a city where there's going to be an alt-right rally today. I don't know if you've heard that term, alt-right. So that's a term, one of many terms for white supremacists. And so in his city today, there's going to be a group of people who look to spread hate and fear and racism and violence in their community. Because of the disturbing events that have been going on across America, and I'm especially mindful of, and you might be as well, of Charlottesville, Virginia, where three people were killed 2 weeks ago, and many others were injured, and it all came about through hate and fear and violence, all those things that were being preached at that white supremacist rally. More and more faith communities are banding together to pray fervently for peace among people and among cultures and throughout our nations. And today especially, Jeff and his parishioners are going to meet hatred with love. They are going to meet fear with faith. They are going to meet violence with peace. The power of standing on a strong foundation. God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit will help Pastor Jeff and the people of his parish and all the people that gathered for that rally today to protest against the ugliness that's going to be preached at that rally. It will help all of them to look into the face of ugliness today and to remind people about the greatest commandment, the great commandment of Jesus, love one another as I have loved you. By this, all people will know that you are my disciples if you have love for one another. We have a fabulous gospel reading before us today from Matthew 16, and it focuses on this very thing, what it means to stand on Jesus as the firm foundation, the rock-solid foundation of life and of ministry for you and me, for all those faithful followers who come before us, for all who will come after us. The name Caesarea Philippi, it's a name in scripture that's associated with a lot of power. So this was a place at the southwestern foot of Mount Hebron, a beautiful mountain there on the northwest side of Israel. And Mount Hebron and Caesarea Philippi were seen as seats of power, both of the deities of the Greek gods, but also of the Roman and Jewish rulers. The Greeks had erected a temple there, a shrine there, and made a grotto there to honor the Greek god Pan. So the Greek god Pan is one of those multi-gods. Pan is the god of nature and the god of music. And in the lifetime of Jesus, this was named Caesarea Philippi to honor the Roman ruler, Caesar Augustus, and the Jewish ruler, Philip, also known as Philip the Tetrarch of Judea. So in that seat of power, where Pan was worshipped and where Caesar and where Philip were seen as powerful people, there's Jesus and his disciples. And Jesus asks them two very defining questions. The first is, who do people say that I am? And the second one is, but who do you say that I am? So when he asks them the first questions, all of the disciples have answers. They say, well, some people say that you're John the Baptist. Or some people say that you're Elijah or Jeremiah or one of the great prophets who went before us. So these were all great comparisons to the ancestors in faith who had come before Jesus. But the most defining question is the personal one that Jesus asks. And but what do you think? Who do you say that I am?" And only Peter is brave enough and bold enough to say what's on his heart. "You are the Messiah, the Son of the living God." And in some translations it says, "You are the Christ, the Son of the living God." Jesus promised on that day that he would build his church around Peter, around that kind of bold faith. And he called Peter the rock. Well, you and I know from Scripture, certainly from the night Jesus was betrayed, that Peter was not so bold, that he wavered in his faith, and that he betrayed Jesus three times. When Peter's faith was tested and on shaky ground, Jesus stayed the strong foundation of love and forgiveness that Peter needed. And when our faith is shaky and on unstable ground, Jesus is also that strong foundation of love and forgiveness that we need as God's people. The questions that Jesus asked on that day in Caesarea Philippi are just as defining for you and for me as 21st century Christians. We can give a lot of different answers, just like the disciples did, if somebody asked us who Jesus is. From what we've heard, from what we have learned through Scripture and through Bible study, from what we've heard and read and learned, we can give a lot of different answers. But the question of Jesus, "But who do you say that I am?" is one that still hits the human heart, that still asks us to dig deep inside and to say what's on our heart, to reply in total faith and trust. With Jesus, we have the everlasting power of a strong foundation to face anything in life, knowing that we're saved and that we're loved. On the night before his death, Martin Luther King came up with six principles for Christians to live by. And maybe you've heard those, or maybe you haven't, but you can find these online. And I think there are beautiful words for us today to contemplate as we think about all the hatred and violence and division in America over so many things. And I think they're great for us to think about as Christian people, as to how to live our lives in harmony. The six principles of nonviolence. The first one is, nonviolence is a way of life for courageous people. The second one is, the beloved community, the church, is the framework for the future, respect and faithfulness and partnership. The third principle is, attack the forces of evil, but don't attack the people who are doing evil. The fourth is, accept suffering without retaliation to further the cause and achieve the goal of Christian harmony. The fifth is, avoid internal violence of the spirit as well as external physical violence. And the last one is, the universe is on the side of justice and peace. All major religions, any that are God-centered, they all focus on what it is to live in peace, to live in justice. May Christ, who is the strong foundation, bless you with peace and hope and love on this day and always. Amen.